Hello guys, and this is John Ragequit, and this is going to be my first game where I play with a sub. So, yeah, this is a message to everyone who wants to play with me. It's like I don't say no to a game. So, if you're up for playing a game with me, just like add me on EU West, and we'll see if we can sort something out. Actually, because the Champions League was so messy, I used my wrong masteries, but it only matters on like one point where I don't have the jungle buff extension, so I'm not really too worried about it. So the sub I'm playing with is Mikal's Place YouTube, and we actually up onto Skype. So yeah, it's nice to play with a sub. It like shows that you are actually like connecting to people and would like to watch your content. So that's it feels good. I have to say it feels good to play with a subscriber. So yeah, I'm looking forward to doing this more often if people are up for it. And of course I had to play Skarner. Well, he wanted me to play Skarner, so you request, I do what you want. Ish. Like I will, it's like if you ask me to play a champion that I love playing, and I will say yes. And if you ask me, like, "Hey, go play Yasuo and feel like an idiot," no thanks. Something like that. So yeah, it's like my intention was to like focus a little bit more on the top lane. And here you got actually got XP from it, and I didn't notice it, but it doesn't really matter. And the reason why my screen is freezing now is because I'm accepting the Skype call. So yeah, you said to me like, "Hey, I can help you with the red buff," and I was like, "No, you don't. No, you don't need to." And I was like, "Oh wait, I'm level one. Oh well, doesn't really matter." So I got the potion, the increased heal from the potion, so that actually helps me to get through it easier. I actually noticed throughout the game that little XP that I was behind actually sets me back quite a lot at certain points. It's like I can't really say it like now when I look after the game, but when I was playing the game itself, I actually really felt like at certain points that XP that I lacked was setting me back a little bit, because I was like, "Hey, if I just had a little bit more XP, then I would have made it." So I made it level up. So now just the standard, clear everything. It's like yeah, I'm actually calling for him to flash, and he flashes on time, so that's a good escape. And you can, I don't know, I have this feeling that this Kha'Zix and Maokai are pre-mid, because they constantly are. Kha'Zix will constantly gank the top lane. So yeah, Skarner, as you can see, is so hell. This just does not. It's like the jungle, you don't give two shits about it. And I actually prefer to start topside over bottom side, because it's like when you are playing on the top, the stun that you get from the golem will make you clear the jungle in a nicer way than starting the bottom side on blue, because that poison actually doesn't help you that much, whereas the stun like continuously stuns the mobs, which makes you take less damage, which really helps. So here I'm gonna see if I can get a gank going. So I just move up to him, because I want to slow him. I'm actually doing like no damage whatsoever at the moment. He flashes, I flash behind him, but then the minions block me, and I fail the gank, so that sucks. At least I got his flash out. And here Yasuo pings that he's coming, but I'm like, I'm gonna shove the wave really quickly into his tower. Deny him deny that Malzahar some delicious farm. And plus, I was being a bit salty about missing the like failing the gank properly, so I just decided to get some gold for myself and some XP. So these people are actually really busy with my Dominion pillars all the time, taking them back whenever I took them. So I want to come for a gank. But as you can see, he has wards there, so I just decided to recall. Get some items. going for boots. Because I don't really have the gold for health crystals, so I just go boots instead. Can see Kha'Zix at the mid lane. Fucking about. I was like, for some reason these people were really busy around my jungle for once, instead of like letting me just farm around. So, I said this with Skarner at the moment, I think he's so underappreciated. It's like, I've been saying it so many times, like he's so underappreciated. I think he's like one of the strongest junglers in the game at the moment. But he doesn't get played that much because people are like, oh, he isn't that flashy. He just walks up to people, ults them, and then you CC them, and that's about it. But I think maybe it's because this is the champion I got my first pentacle with. I think Skarner has such a charm for me because I just love the champion. And maybe that's why I'm a bit biased and think he's one of the best junglers, obviously. But it's like I've been so successful with him. I haven't been losing at all with him. Yeah, like, here's what I mean. Like, what the fuck is Tashi doing there in my jungle? I was like, okay, so you want to sit in my jungle here? Go have a spoopy. It's like, I don't know what this people's obsession is with my the minion crystals. It's like, it's my fucking crystal. Here you can see Kha'Zix up top. So I warn ye of the fact that he might be coming top, because that's what I saw him do before as well, that he just like, and as you can see here went top. It's like, this person is so predictable now. And I should actually use this to my advantage and like gank other lanes when Kha'Zix is busy top. Or I should just, what's even more funny is like to actually gank top lane and murder Maokai all the time and see how their team reacts to it. It's like, eh. So yeah, and this is the moment where I was like, fuck, if I only had that XP from that minion buff. From the camp at the start. So yeah, I just hope for that minion to die quickly. So I can ult. So yeah, I can ult. So I just ult him. So, nice kill. I just ult him to be sure. It's like, I didn't know if... Oh, he can't have flash because my flash isn't up yet, but... I just wanted to make 100% sure that he was dead. It's like, I don't care. It's like, I should have looked at my own flash and saw that, and I should have seen that he couldn't have had it up. But it doesn't really matter. So here I'm like, fuck, I can't really do this at the moment. It's like I'm feeling a bit too. It's like, you can see that the dragon did way too much damage. But fortunately, Yasuo comes to help, so it means we can do it anyway. It's like, it's always so interesting. That's so interesting with League of Legends. Like, when you random hook, yeah, I'm like, shit, let's not get randomly killed. It's not worth that much, that thing. It's so interesting with Lee, because you have like one game where you went like super good with Skarner, and then you sort of like have that in your mind that you do that much damage, and then you like, for example, that first gank, and then there on the dragon, it's like, I felt like I could like easily kill them, but but I couldn't. And yeah, Thresh is fucking around in my jungle again. I'm like, what the fuck is happening here? It's like, this game was confusing me so much. Oh. Barely survives Maokai, bit lucky on Maokai's part. But that's like, I have no clue why the fuck people are like so, or at least Thresh is so eager to gank me in the jungle. It's like, he's on his own, it's like he can't really kill me. But I'd rather not fight, because he always, it's like, it's probably like a pre-mid in the sense that they're like waiting in the wings for the hook or something. Or he's just there to annoy me, either way. Either way, fuck him, and I'm just gonna run away and make him waste his time. So that our bot lane can get more head on XP. Second, I don't want to waste my time on him either. It's like, I could kill him. Or I could not, or he could just like fucking be annoying long enough for the teammates to show up, because I don't feel that confident in my damage. Like, look at what I have no items. So, it's gonna take me a while to kill him. And as you can see here, because he's wasting too much time, their Caitlyn is getting killed all the time. So was it worth roaming all the time? No, it wasn't. So here, yeah, I'm gonna go and come in for another gank. I have my ultimate up, so... Yeah, and I accidentally flashed because I had my hands wrong on the keyboard, so I accidentally flashed. Got Monster Flash out of it as well. So that was nice. So I got for my field. It's like I actually look like a total ass out here. It's like, hey, let's go flash in. I was like, fuck, I have my hand wrong on my keyboard. So yeah, I'm like, I'll give you my fucking crystal back again. So you can take it later, but at least I have the benefit of using it right now a little bit. It's like I felt like such an ass there. It's like, I flashed in because I had my hands wrong on the keyboard. I don't even remember what the fuck I was trying to press. I think I had my hands so wrong on the keyboard that I pressed on my that I wanted to press E but I flashed instead. So if you look at it under your keyboard right now, then you can see how fucking wrong I had my hands there. You must see fights with Mao and gets the kill. So that's very good. So that Maokai is like, I don't know what the fuck this Maokai is doing, but he's so non-existent in this game at the moment. It's like he's farming like a potato. He's not pushing anything. He's constantly being pushed. And I'm like, okay, now I can take you. Let's go fight. Yeah, I can see that Malta is coming, but Yasuo is not coming. So I'm just see what's gonna happen, but nothing's gonna happen. So I'm like, decide to go bot lane because I know the trash is in the mid lane. So I'm like, fuck you, noob. And Ezreal's like, fuck you, noob too. Not gonna help you. So I hit my E, but then she like nets away, and I'm like, eh, fuck it. If Ezreal isn't coming, then I'm gonna leave as well. So for me, at this point in time, the game is very, very frustrating, if I have to say. It's like failing my flash, and everything is like such a bad impression, is like, you know what I mean? And I just felt shit. In the sense that, like, I want to make fucking kills and I want to win this game, but we're very good on score right now, but yeah. Must he escapes again. Very nice. But yeah. It's like you just want to win the game, you want to play, like, have a, like every game. It's like you want to have be that one person that goes like 10-1 or 10-0 or 10-2, whatever. It's like I have a 6 score. That's why I feel a bit like, I want to have 6 score, but my ganks aren't working out. It's like I'm only like 0-0-1. So here I go for the gank on the top lane. I actually want to wait for Master Yi. But since he's already moving off, I have to like intercept him now. So, and apparently there, as for the minion, so here, welcome to the world of fails as well this game, because I've already done like 3 complete doo-doos. But then he does a doo-doo as well. But apparently you can dodge my ulti because he's the one that actually does the damage right now. So he dies there. And then Master Yi gets the kill to me, which is very nice. It's not really needed, but it was very nice from him. But yeah, so this is looking better now. But that was like I completely doo-doo 3 times already, like twice with my fucking flash and everything, so it's like, ugh. I was feeling like such a fucking pleb. It's like, mate, how can you play so bad? But then, it's like the thing is as well, this is a nice thing as well, it's like, you need to not tilt. It's like, not be like, oh no, I'm playing bad, oh no, everything is shit now, and then now I need to overcompensate. I was just still playing like how I always play with Skarner. It's just like going deep everywhere and trying to make kills, but in a safe way. But so it's like you shouldn't like overextend now, because you're like, oh, I'm not going that well. Because I see people do that. It's like they are like, oh, I'm not going that well, so I'm gonna go really deep, and then they like tower dive and die. So, yeah, I'm just gonna keep on playing and see if I can pull it back. So those 2 kills really helped me to get me going in the right direction. Get some nice a nice gold injection. So Musty actually almost died there. So now I'm gonna see if I can help him get a kill Maokai. So like Kha'Zix, you want to babysit top? I can babysit top too. So here, now I'm actually was waiting for his Twisted Advance, but he wasn't using it. Same like mate, let's go tower tower tanking. So we go here deep. So I try to pull him out of the tower. And here's a fucking trash. And yeah, I try to stun trash so he doesn't get yee, but here he gets flashed and I'm like, okay, I'm out. Bye bye. Weak. I win. So yeah. That was a bit unfortunate that the mid lane showed up. But Mossy got a kill, I got assist, so. And yeah, I'm like, okay, it's probably on his own, but then I can see Mozart, so I'm like, oh fuck, I just want to run. And I really don't want to use my flash, and here I want to stun him into the tower. And this is. I get the kill here. But I also die. So. Was it worth it? Arguably not. But. I got a nice gold again, so I'm like, okay. I'm fine with this. It's like, I don't really feel like Malta is going to be that much of a problem. We have so much things that take his ult out. So now I'm getting near my first sexy item. Well, near, that's like still like 150 gold away, 1050 gold away. But yeah, as I was saying, it's like we have so much CC to knock Malta out of his ultimate, so I'm not really. I got attacks there, so that's why I stopped talking. So we got like knock up, like Nami bubble, my ult, Nami ultimate. There are all the flashes though. And yeah, not really too worried about it. So yeah, I'm gonna see if I can help Nami. I'm probably not gonna be in time. So yeah, wasn't in time. So I'm like, oh, so you want to move out of position. Flash. E. Dead. Nice 300 gold. He's like, wow. It's like, yeah. It's like, why the fuck not, mate? It's like, I got another 300 gold, which gets me going even more. So I don't care. I must have got another kill. Very good. You flashed. It's like, well played. I was like, mid. Now I got another kill. It's like, seriously, it's like, why wouldn't you? It's like, I understand that sometimes. It's like, if you have a support that goes 0-8, then I understand if you're like, wow, why would you flash on me? But here he was 1-3 and he was being a fucking annoying shithead. And I was like, fuck you, noob. Well, not noob, but fuck you. It's like, I want to get revenge for you fucking my shit up. It's like, for you roaming around that you're in the top lane. Fucking shit up at Malta and you're fucking around in my jungle. It's like, fuck you. It's like you have to pay for your crimes. So yeah, I noticed that I don't have enough gold, so I want to clear another camp. So that's the kind of the way I tilt-ish. It's like if you start, it's like, it tends to be a decent way of tilting at least. Because you take someone out who's being really annoying and fucking your team up. So. This trash, in my opinion, is the person who's the most annoying in their team. Not the most dangerous, but the most annoying person. The most dangerous one is probably Kha'Zix. But, as you can see here, yeah, this damage is fucking crazy. Yeah, too bad. But, Kha'Zix is the dangerous, but trash is the most annoying with that fucking hook and everything. And this guy, this trash was actually kinda good and kinda trying to make plays, but yeah, he left his bottom lane so alone that Kaylin is worth jack shit. Which is really stupid in my opinion. So you still have should have your AD carry at a decent point, because if the enemy team has an AD carry and you don't, then yeah, I've had it so many times that you simply can't win. And I'm like, lol. Get eat, bitch. And he has tower aggro, and then I just kill him like that. And I'm like, okay, so he's dead too, because I have so much sticking potential, it's like there's no way he's gonna get away. Oh, maybe with a sapling that was already waiting there. But I'm not intending to. And if he goes back on me, that doesn't really matter because I get out of the CC quick enough. So here, 2 kills. So now I'm 6-1. Slowly racking up the kills. So yeah, I'm getting pretty fed now. and I'm liking it, so I can get going on my Rage Blade, which will help me a lot. So I opt for the AP item first, so I get bigger shields, which means that I can trade longer. So like, I always like doing it that way, because that AP scales a little bit better on in the way I want it to. It's like I want to be a bit more tanky, and I want my magic damage to just do more. So as you can see, Kaylin has so little items that she can't even properly tower push at this point in time. So like, we're already quite far into the game, so... if you can't really push towers as a Kaylin at this point, then you know that you're behind. Like, and it's the first hour, it's like the outer tower as well. So here I'm looking to help Musty. I managed to hit the slow on him in the E. Stun him, he's dead, no problem. Easy kill. It's like if you hit that E, it's like always worth chasing. Even like when they use that mobility, because it's like your E slows so much. Here Musty goes deep and I'm like, okay, now I have to go deep too. So here I get ultied by, or grabbed by Thresh. I'm like, shit, now I need to run. I was like, oh crap, oh crap, oh crap. And now he's like helping me. So I'm like, maybe I can brawl a little bit longer. So she heals me and I can see his HP. So I tried to bush, fuck him up with the bush, and I did. So now I have to run again. It's like the Thresh is really keeping me stuck. But Nami saves the day, shields me, heals me, and gives me boost. So yeah, that was really well played for me and Nami. But then Malta, he got like, it's like he face checked that bush because I didn't think they had vision there. And that's what I was banking on, that they didn't have vision there. And yeah, Yasuo makes a kill with Nami, so awesome. But it's like I've been fucked over that way so many times that people walk into a bush and then kill me from the bush. Because they can see me, but I can't see them. So that's exactly what I did to that Malzahar. It's like I made it sure that he couldn't see me. And I just moved, and then I just killed him really quickly with the EQ combo. So I'm like, ah, it's only Thresh. I can easily smite this one before he can take it. Especially if Nami gets grabbed. And then Yi kills Maokai, so Maokai is heavily shut down. Good job for me and Yi, like, shutting him down. I was like, and here I actually thought that I gave away the blue to Ezreal, and he said thanks. And I was like, why the fuck did I get it? It's like, even my English went a total donkey there. Why I got it? It's because you did. Probably like a last thing for my red buff or something stupid, I don't know. That I don't know if he even had it, but it's like something fucking gave it to me. I don't even know what. Well, at least I tried to give it. So, do I get points for that? Probably not, but yeah, Musty goes in, and I'm like, you're just gonna follow. They are like, oh crap, oh crap. So I try to like stall them enough, but it doesn't really help. So I ulti Kha'Zix, see if I can kill him. And he actually survives with like no HP whatsoever, so I have to flash away. Now I'm for the help again. So yeah, that was a bit too much. It's a typical, hey, I engage and suddenly like the rest of the team is behind that person. Happens to everyone, so... yeah, it happened to me quite a lot as well. So I'm like, hey, let's go kill this person! Oh, nope! And then you die. So it's kinda... kinda funny, but it's not like they can get anything out of it at this point. It's like they're so weak. It's like, look at that Caitlyn, complete shite. Because Thresh is roaming. It's like, it's a good thing to roam as a support, don't get me wrong. But this Thresh roamed to the point where his bot lane was complete. Like, got completely worse. Because there's no way you can come back if you're behind, if your support leaves you. Because how the fuck are you supposed to farm when you have two people who are constantly engaging on you? It's like, it's almost impossible to farm. So yeah, I'm like, okay, let's go kill Maokai. Hello, mate. And he did it again. I'm like, fuck. Forgot about it. So you can actually, like, counter my E by twisting advancing, because apparently, even though you travel through it, it doesn't really hurt you. Doesn't really get you. And yeah, like, oh, stacks. And yeah, Masi comes in. He actually gives it to me, so that's nice. And here, just take the tower. Tower and the kill. Nice. Although, Maokai's not worth it much anymore, but fuck him. See, I'm going for Lit in Vain. See what I can find. So I can melt ultimate, I'm kind of confident that I can take on Kha'Zix anyway with Master so close to me. It's gonna take back a little bit of the buffs. Oh, not the buff, I'm gonna take this vision thing. And then afterwards take that thing, that's what I meant with buff. Well, it is a buff. So here they're like, we want to kill Kha'Zix, but they're showing up again, all of them. So here I'm trying to help out again, but you just have to run. So I'm like, shit, run. Like, no, the damage, and dead. And then I quickly look at the damage, and I was like, fuck. Oh, that sucked. And they instantly take back my crystals. My crystals. So I'm actually getting into the Witch End land, and I'm like, ooh. It means I'm gonna have a shitload of attack speed, that's nice. Surprising how little damage that Kaylin does. Wow, and she missed her Q there. As well. That was literally fails all around. Not that I'm exempt from failing, as you can see in the early game, but it's really kind of interesting how we, like, twice, me and Masti at the same spot, got piled by their team. It's like just above the mid lane there. So Masti's found Kha'Zix again. Because he has to flash now. Then ulti away. And I'm like, haha, Kha'Zix, let's go. So with my double split I can like catch up to him. Yeah, I like managed to hit him with the smite. And you're like, fuck, again, the second time you survive with such low HP. So I hit my abilities just right, but I just lacked that little last bit of damage to kill him. And I'm like, I want my crystal back. Eh. And then I can see how far Maokai is and I'm like, okay, let's go just kill Maokai again. It's like he's already worth nothing, but let's just make his game even more miserable. So yeah, and it's like, this is kind of sad that the entire team shows up to kill him, but apart from Ezreal. So I'm like, eh, why not take the Baron? So this is like the worst thing we can ever do. So I actually get hooked. And then they just like CC me dead. Yep. Just well played from them. It's like a horrible place for us to fight, but yeah. Can't deny that they just played well and killed us there. It's like you sometimes just have to, but you can't sit in and say that was bullshit. Oh, bullshit this, oh, bullshit that. They just played well. It's like the nice hook that caught me. And then they just finished me off. It's like it's just really nice. Nice tower dive as well. So I have to say, nice attempt at pulling the big game back. It's like it helped him to get a lot of gold. So, yeah. I'm not gonna sit there and say that was bullshit. Oh, that was just, well, we just got wrecked there. So I'm like, looking at all the objects on the map, I'm like, what are they gonna do? It's like I don't understand why they didn't take Baron. It's like they should have taken Baron right there. Because their entire team was dead. So instead they opt for taking top lane, so I'm gonna come as well. Flash from Maokai, so just run after Kaylin. Just need to get a smite on her. So get the smite there. I place a ward so we have vision, then I E. Then I get the kill. Nice. Now I'm just like, hey, let's go take the fucking Baron. It's like if they don't want it, then we can take it. And it's like, I really don't understand, it's like, but that's just the thing, it's like, these people weren't that high level, and you can see it in this kind of place where they leave the Baron. And I'm like, dude, it's like, I know the Baron is kind of a healthy objective, but it's like, if our entire team is dead for so long, you don't go to the top lane and push a tower when Baron's up, you take that Baron. Because because you didn't take it, we have it, and we got all the gold from it. And now we can push objectives with it. And like all you got was like a tower or two. And that's it. It's like if you want to capitalize on what you if you win a fight, it's like you've been losing all game long. And then you get like that opportunity, that golden opportunity to get back into the game. And then you don't take it because you're like, hey, let's not take the Baron. And here I just flash him because it's all the damage, and if I have my ultimate, they have no damage there because Caitlyn is complete shite at this point. So I'm like, okay, so now the Kha'Zix is dead, so that means that I can just push away the tower. Six is not like the only person now that can like fuck us up is Maltzar, and there he is. So I'm like, fuck, let's go run away. Because I don't want to get CC'd and killed by Maltzar. So yeah, I actually tried to stand in front of the hook, but I failed. So we managed to kill Thresh, and yeah, I'm like, okay, well. Fuck, now I need to run. It's quite interesting how that Maokai went on Thresh when I was the one who's actually killing Thresh. Went on Masty when I was actually the person killing them there. But, I don't care. I got a kill out, and now I can just move. I move straight to the mid lane and get another tower there. So that's three towers, push with the Baron. But here you can see like how important it is to just take that objective. Like, if you get a chance, take it. Come on. It's like, don't be like these people and not take it. Yeah, I actually get my Witch Hunter, it's really nice. And I'm like, what item am I missing? So I'm looking and thinking, I'm like, here, yeah, I see that, I see Sheen. I'm like, oh yeah, shit, Iceborne Gauntlet, that was the last item in this build. So I buy the Iceborne, so I buy the Sheen. Which is gonna be an Iceborne Gauntlet for X maximum sticking potential. Because you're getting sped up by a Deadman Split, and you're slow with your basic text when you use a spell, which, as Karna, you do a lot. So, it's almost always like, when it's up again, you proc it instantly again, because you're spamming so much. So I'm here looking for some shenanigans, see if some people are here. So far no one. So now I'm wondering where they are, and I can see them now in the bot lane. In the bot jungle. So yeah, I have to say, it was fun. Really fun to play with a subscriber at... Yeah, it just makes you feel, it's like, it makes you feel good, and at the same time, it's like now, I'm only at like, what, 37, 35 subscribers, but it feels like I have a lot, and to me that feels like a lot, because I didn't expect to get any subscribers at all, I didn't expect to get that many views to begin with. It's like, of course I have that Diablo video with like, 11k views. Which is really nice, but I also have like views on my other videos, and people like to see my League of Legends content, and hopefully also my Legion Alpha content. Which is just basically a sort of like a let's play, but not really, because I'm like testing out shit, and I'm looking at stuff. So yeah, I'm like, okay, now you fucked up, son. Ulti him, and then you can just finish him off. So yeah, it makes you feel like you're actually doing something that people want to watch, and yeah, I didn't expect it, and I know that the key to getting more people to watch it is consistency, and well, obviously you need to have something that makes you people want to watch you. So you have to leave Mossy again. It's like I want to be able to help him, but it's like sometimes you just can't do anything about it, so that sucks. Yeah. It's like I saw Yasuo coming on the minimap. And yeah, Nami's there with me. It's like, and then I feel like I can do anything I want. Because she can interrupt the ult. Well, she didn't do that there, but she's... She keeps me healthy enough to not die to it. But yeah, it's like, so you need to have something and then just keep making content. It's like you can't sit there and like make two videos and then give up. So it's like, if people want to like get going on making videos, so like, just be yourself. It's like, I don't want to be like that idiot person, like that, like, I just want to be who I am myself. And make the videos I am happy with, and that's the most important. Make videos that you are happy with. And yeah, I just take all the objectives so that the minions will push it down eventually. And I just want to go back because I want to finish my build. Could have probably pushed a lot more there. But I just want to finish my build. So that's the reason why I don't finish it there. If I'm honest. So yeah, just keep making, just make content that you're happy with. And Yeah, I'm hoping that I one day will get to a point where I get like a shitload of viewers and shit. But that's not really the main goal. The main goal is that I make videos that I'm happy with, and if people want to watch them, that's just an extra. And I really appreciate like everyone who's been watching my videos. Just want to say that again. It's like it's been. It's like it makes you want to do it. It's like I have a really busy job now, so I have to get up at like 6 in the morning, and then I come back, and then I'm like kind of tired, but I still want to like keep making videos for people to watch. 7x6, come here, because he's like the main threat. So I'm like, here, Kaelin, come here now. I'm like, I'm stuck between the entire team, let's go run away now. So, yeah, thanks thanks everyone for like watching my videos. And yeah, this is like a sort of like appreciation video, because it's also with a subscriber, so it's like I just want to say how much I appreciate everyone who's like watching my stuff and like commenting and everything. I know that I like, it's like the reason why I don't make that many, it's like people who are watching for Diablo is like, I'm sorry for that, because I'm kinda, it's like I've got so many other things to play now. And him like accidentally walked inside, but for some reason that Kaelin ult didn't do any damage. It's like, I'm sorry about that Diablo, but yeah. It's like I'm busy with other stuff now. I don't really have the time to play, or the time to play Diablo, but I'll see what I can do about that. So, another kill. And here they surrender. Or here they not surrender, but here they lose 2 minions. And that was the game, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. I enjoyed it, and yeah, if you want to play with me as a subscriber or viewer, just ask me in the comments and we'll see what we can do. And I'll talk to you guys later.